let's go ahead and understand nomenclature of the lens. All right. This is how we speak about the lenses. Let us start from this lens, which is our workhorse. This is a 100 mm lens. All right. It is not a range. There's a single number over here. 100. That's it. Fixed. So we call this lens as a lens having fixed focal length. Now we are entering into the details. So what is focal length? Let me tell you what is the meaning of focal length. Let me define it for you first. All right. Focal length is defined as the distance from the objective till the maximum point of convergence when the lens is focused at infinity. This is what it means. All right. But it is not so important. The definition of focal length is not so important. But if you want to hear it again, it is defined as the distance from the objective till the maximum point of convergence when the lens is focused at infinity. Let's not go into the detail of this lens. But what it actually means is, what I usually tell my students is, it's approximately the physical size of the lens. For example, 100 mm means 10 centimeters. So a lens with approximately 10 centimeter size is a 100 mm lens. That's what I tell all my delegates. Similarly, this is a 50 mm lens. All right. So around 5 centimeter lens is a 50 mm lens. It is almost approximately equal to the physical size of the lens. All right. So this is the focal length, and depending upon the focal length, our lenses have different effects that happen on our camera body. But before going into the effects, let me tell you, if you see any one number on the lens, over here is 50 mm. So these lenses are called lenses with a fixed focal length or prime lenses. So this is a prime lens. 50 mm is a prime lens. Again, over here, 100 mm is also a prime lens. This is 65 mm. Again, it's a prime lens. However, this does not have a single number. It has a range, 18 to 55. These lenses, you can set the focal length of your choice. You can set it at 18, you can set it at 24, you can set it at 35, you can set it at 55. So the minimum focal length over here is 18 mm and the maximum is 55 mm. So that's why this lens is called 1855 lens. Okay. And since you are zooming out and you can also zoom in. So this is the zoom in and this is the zoom out. Since you can zoom in and zoom out, it's called as a zoom lens. So whenever we have a range written on the lens, like 1855, this is a range. So whenever I talk about two numbers, it means it's a range, and this lens is called as a zoom lens. So this is a zoom lens and this is a prime lens. Prime lens has only one number in it. Zoom lens has a range written on it. All right. Hello, Vishal Gupta, sir. I'm really glad to have you here. Hi, Saif. Hi, Sana. So we just now discussed what are the type of lenses that we have in any kind of photography. All right. So whenever you have two numbers written on the lens, it's a range. That those lenses are called as zoom lenses, and a prime lens is a lens with a single number. So this is a prime lens. All right. Now we go ahead and we try and understand how focal length helps us take different pictures. All right. So just imagine 50 mm, just imagine a line, okay? 50 mm is the center of the line. So 50 mm lens, like this lens, is called as a normal lens. This is the center of your line. Anything which is less than 50 mm will be considered as a wide angle lens. It is used to take landscape pictures. Anything which is more than 50 is called as a telephoto lens, all right? So it is used to take pictures of far off things like wildlife photography and stuff like that. Let us see what difference does it make for us physically. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you live how things are looking at different focal lengths. All right. So let me focus it a bit for you. Yeah. So right now I'm at 18 mm focal length. You can see 18 mm focal length. So in 18 mm, you can see a wide area. All right. Let me change the focal length to 24 mm. So now it's on 24 mm. You can see it's a bit closer to me. I'm going to 35 mm. You can see this white color line. Now it looks even more closer to me. All right. And at 55 mm. This is 55 mm. So now it's pretty close to me. Everything looks pretty close to me. So this is 55, 35, 24, and 18. So 18, it's a wide angle. As I'm going towards 55, it's zooming in. So this is the result of different focal lengths. This is what I'm teaching you out here. 50 mm lenses are typically used for portraits, formal portraiture. Wide angle lenses are used for landscape photography, and anything above 55, telephoto lens is used for, like, it depends. If it's 400 mm, it's used for wildlife and stuff like that. All right. Let us see and try to understand it even better. You need to look at this image carefully. Let me get it even closer to you so that you can understand it well. Yeah, look at the image over here. This is 24 mm. If you take a picture in any camera with a 24 mm lens, you'll be able to see a wide area. You can see the orange color line. You can see a wider area because it's a wide angle lens. If you are standing at the same place but you are using a 50 mm lens, you can look at the green color rectangle. You can see only a small space because it's looking more zoomed in. If you take the same picture with a 300 mm, you can see an even smaller area. So basically, the angle of view is reducing if the focal length is increasing. Let me explain it even better. I would like to show you a very interesting thing that one of my students did in one of my courses, and it is very helpful for all of you all to understand it better. So the experiment goes like this. This was done by one of my students, Amruta Sardeshmukh. So what she did was she took a picture with 17 mm lens. So basically, let me explain it to you what she has done. She had one camera and four lenses, 17 mm, 35 mm, 50 mm and 90 mm. She stood at the same place and took these four pictures. As soon as she took a picture with a 17 mm, she could see three walls, the wall table as well as the towel. But now she changed 17 mm to a 35 mm and you can see the ball size has increased. In the sense, it's looking more zoomed in. Now you can see the table, ball as well as two walls and a towel. If you shift to a 50 mm lens, you can see the table and the ball only and almost no walls. But if you shift to a 90 mm, it's looking very close to you. In the sense, now you can see only the ball. So hopefully this will make you understand the use of different focal lengths better. Wide angle for landscape photography, telephoto for stuff to get things close to you. All right. So this is how we need different focal lengths for different kinds of photography. Basically, every focal length is going to be different for different pictures. Similarly, even your phone must be having a focal length. Focal length is typically measured, the scale of measurement is mm, millimeter. So can you tell me what is the focal length of your mobile phone? Your mobile phone also must be having a focal length because it has a lens. Can you tell me what is the focal length of your lens? That'd be interesting to know. So let me go ahead and carry on with the session. Hopefully you understood the meaning of or use of different focal lengths. I probably want to show you some pictures that I have shot. I had been to Assam recently, so I went to Kaziranga National Park. Kaziranga Wildlife Sanctuary. It's not a national park, it's a wildlife sanctuary. Obviously, I cannot go so close to the rhino. So, what lens do you think I must have chosen for this image? Have I taken it from a wide angle lens, a normal lens, or a telephoto lens? Can you tell me what lens I must have used? For this photo of the rhino. Perfect, Indu, you are right. Mobile phones have a wide angle lens, yeah. But in this picture, I have shot this picture with a telephoto lens, and when I took this picture, I was approximately around 400 mm, something like that. So it's obviously a telephoto lens because I cannot go close to the rhinos. In sanctuaries and national parks, you're not allowed to get outside the safari jeep. So basically you cannot go down the jeep. So you need to have lenses which are telephoto. Alright, so this was around 400 mm focal length. Although the lens was 150-600, it was a telephoto zoom lens. 150-600, so it's a telephoto zoom lens. Alright, so let's go ahead and see what could be the focal length in this. What do you think I must have shot this with? This squirrel has been shot with what kind of a lens? Have I used a wide angle lens? Have I used a normal lens? Or have I used a telephoto lens? Yeah, you're right again. I have used a telephoto lens. This one was using a 400 mm lens, kept at 400 mm focal length. So I have used a 400 lens, kept at 400 mm focal length. So this was with a telephoto lens again. Yeah. All right. This was in Australia. Okay, and this I have shot using my drone. Can you tell me what is my focal length over here? Is it in the wide angle category? Is it the normal category? Or is it the telephoto category? What lens must be there for this one? Yeah, Bandesh, you're right. This is a wide angle lens. This is through my drone. I have a DJI Mavic Air, so obviously this is a wide angle lens. You all are right. It's perfect. Right, let's go ahead and see other images. Again, I request people to please share the video so that you can start a watch party, so even others can attend. I really request you all that this, if you find this session interesting and informative, please start a watch party, please share the video so others can also get benefited out of it, because we are going to speak a lot about lenses. Please share the video and start a watch party. Okay, now tell me what I've used for the left hand side image and what I've used for the right hand side image. You can say left hand side answer, like left the so and so focal length and right hand so and so focal length. Can you tell me what it is? What are lenses I must have used? Yeah, you're right. So, wide angle on the left hand side and telephoto on the right hand side. No, I have used a normal lens on the right hand side. So this one was shot with a 50 mm lens and this one was shot with a wide angle lens. So it is not easy to find, look at any picture basically and find out or probably guess what focal length it was shot at. It's a very tough job. It is best not to guess. But this one was shot with a 50mm lens, a normal lens. Right. Hello, Gurkirat sir. Nice to have you. Right. Yeah. Can you tell me what lens was used for this one? What lens you think I would have used for this one? What is the lens I must have used for this one? Yeah. Perfect. Most of you have answered the earlier answer correct. So let us go ahead and see what lens I must have used for this one. Hello, Dhwani. Nice to see you in the session. Yeah, Anand, you're right. This was with a macro lens. So the lens I used for this one is a 100mm non-IS lens. Is the same lens that I have in my hand right now. 100mm macro non-IS. I took this without image stabilization. So even without image stabilization, you get amazing pictures. So don't underestimate the power of this lens. This is a normal macro lens, a 100mm macro lens. It's not a super macro lens is what I'm saying. Hello, Dr. Rajiv Chetgopi sir. So awesome to see you. Yeah, Gaurav, this is not MPE65. This is a 100mm macro lens. This is not a super macro. Okay, even this is a 100mm macro lens that you can see. Even this one is without the image stabilization. Okay, even this is a 100mm macro lens. So yeah, this locust was very big actually, so it has occupied the full frame. Okay, the insect was very big. Okay, what do you think I must have used for this one? Any guesses? This is a 100-400 lens. It must be kept at some focal length. I can't remember what focal length, but it's a 100-400 lens. It is a very good lens for getting a bokeh effect. Hello, Neha. I hope Rahul is also watching. This is with a 100mm macro lens. So it's very, very difficult to guess what lens must have used for what, but this is a 100mm macro lens. This is a 100-400 lens for sure, but I can't remember what focal length it was shot at. This is a 100mm macro lens. Okay, this is also a 100mm macro lens. For this image, I remember I spent 1 week of hard work I had done for this one. But ultimately, I got this drop right in this height. Behind, I've kept a flag. So there's a drop of water in front. The flag behind is upside down so that inside the water, you can see right side up. So a lot of thought process has gone into the making of this image. So this is a 100mm macro lens. This is also a 100mm macro lens. Everything is with this lens only. 100mm macro non-IS. Everything is with this lens. There's also the tea is actually water with different colors. It's not actual tea. But you can grab a cup of tea for yourself right now. Maybe this image would be like that. Okay. Now tell me, what is this lens? I really want you all to have a good look at this fly's eyes and look at this picture and tell me what lens I have used for this. Can you guess? Can you take a wild guess and try to tell me what lens this must be? The fly image I would have shot it with what lens? Let us see how many of you get it right. Pala Kurti Kiran, thank you for sharing. Liji, please share and start a watch party so others can see. Vishal Gupta sir is saying super macro. Indu Mohan is saying macro. Sachin is saying telephoto. No. Seema ma'am is saying 100mm macro. Bhushan is saying 100mm. Anybody else? Om Joshi is saying it's a super. So it looks like a super macro. Indu is saying super macro. Anirban is saying 100mm macro. All right. It's tough. But the answer might shock everyone. This image was shot with 1855 lens. This image was shot with an 1855 lens. It's not even a macro lens. This image was shot with a 1855 lens. Can you believe that? So what I had done is, I did not have money to buy a macro lens before. So what I had done is, I had bought macro filters. So macro filters come in many diopters, 1+, 2+, 5+, and 10+. So I had stacked all the macro filters together. So it had become like this thick. And I had put all the macros on my 1855 lens. So just imagine that instead of this single UV filter, I have four macro filters attached on my lens like this. And then I took this shot. Okay, so there are, just imagine four macro filters. So it's become so thick. I had kept it at 55mm like this, four macro filters, and I had taken this shot. So you can do a lot of stuff even with 1855 lens, but just keep it to leisure photography. There's no point in using 1855 with macro filters attached for dental photography. It's very difficult to use. Depth of field is very shallow. You can see you have very restricted depth of field. Okay, so I had taken this shot at 55mm on 1855 lens, but I had four or five macro filters attached to this. Alright, so macro filters, they are good for leisure photography. Please don't use them for dental photography. Hello Sujit sir, it's amazing to have you in my session. Yeah, alright, so let's go ahead. This one was shot recently. This is Roxy. She is an amazing pet. So I had taken a picture of her eyes in my studio at 100mm focal length. 100mm macro was used for this shot. This one was taken with a 50mm lens. All the kids are playing. So this was in Manali. It was a very cold day, but Manali has a lot of hot water springs. And at that time I was just carrying a 50mm lens. So this image was taken with a 50mm lens. So I had to move quite away from the subjects to take this shot. All right. So you can see amazing landscape in front of you. And there is a contrasting vehicle, a yellow in color. I love this frame. I want you all to guess what would be the focal length for this one. Any guesses what focal length would I have used for this shot? Is it the wide angle? Is it a normal or is it telephoto? So I have taken this shot with a normal lens. That's a 50mm lens because I wasn't carrying any wide angle lenses. So it is not necessary that you can take only portraits with these lenses. You can take anything. It's just that instead of many mountain ranges, I have got only one mountain range. That's because the view is quite zoomed in already because of a 50mm lens. So if I would have taken it with a 24mm lens, obviously it would have looked much better. But my basic point is, it is difficult to guess what will be the focal length of an image just looking at the picture. I could have taken this landscape even with this lens, 100mm lens. So the car would have come even more closer to me, and maybe I would have got only this much of the area in my picture. So you can make aesthetic looking pictures with any lens. It's just that you should have a good vision in your mind. You should have a good visualization. Alright, so this was shot with a 50mm normal lens, not a landscape lens. Again, this was in Kolkata, my favorite city, the city of happiness. I love this place, especially the sweets. This one was also shot with a 50mm lens. Although it looks like a wide angle lens, it wasn't. It was a 50mm lens. All right, so now tell me what is the lens that I've used for this one. This one is quite exciting. It is a nib of a fountain pen. And can you tell me what I have used over here? This is, yeah, you guys are right. This is a super macro lens, MPE65. This is the lens that I'm talking about. And this was shot at nothing much but 2x magnification, not more than this. Yesterday or in live one, I have shown you that this lens is super crazy. And this becomes so huge at 5x magnification. We saw it in live how we use this lens, and I'm going to show more of it pretty soon. But this image was shot at maybe 1.5x or 2x magnification ratio. So this is a super macro lens. This is also shot with a super macro lens. All right. So it's amazing how much lenses can do for us. This is also MP65. All right. So that is one thing that I wanted to tell you all, and it might be of this is of generalized interest. All right. So this is a zoom lens because it's an 1855 lens. You can actually tell how much zoom in, zoom out is happening. For example, some people say 4x zoom, 4x zoom. So what do we understand by 4x zoom? 4x or anything x, it means the maximum focal length divided by the minimum focal length, that gives you the x. For example, if I'm using 100, 400 lens, so 400 divided by 100, that is 4. So 100 400 lens is called as a 4x zoom lens. So the zoom is 4x. That's how it is. Now you have to understand, more the amount of x, less is the image quality. Means it's more poor quality of an image. So it's better to avoid a major focal length changes in your lens. For example, if it is an 1.5 lens, I would not go ahead with that lens. In fact, I would prefer this lens 1855 because it has less x. Okay, so always lesser amount of x means a better lens. All right, so let's go ahead and talk about this lens. This is a prime lens. So maximum focal length is 50 and minimum is also 50. So it is maybe just 1x. So basically this is not a zoom lens, this is a prime lens. So prime lenses are the best lenses because they cannot zoom in or zoom out. They are amazing lenses to have. Okay, so another example of a lens with 1x means a prime lens would be 100mm macro lens. This is our main lens for dental photography and documentation. So prime lenses are amazing lenses to be used. So try to invest more and more on prime lenses rather than zoom lenses because they're going to give you better image quality. So that's how we decide lenses. Obviously prime lenses are much more expensive than zoom lenses, but it's definitely a worth to invest on prime. Let's talk about this. In live number one, we had discussed about this thing, distortion. Focal length and distortion are related to each other in this manner. All right. Focal length is inversely proportional to distortion. What do we mean by that? Is this. So suppose I have this lens, all right, with me. It is an 1855 lens. If I keep it at 55, I have lesser chances of distortion during dental photography as compared to an 18mm lens. Distortion basically happens when you are using the lens against what it is supposed to be used for. 18mm focal length is for landscapes. The problem happens when you use 18mm for portraits. If you use 18mm for portraits, you're going to get distortion. You're starting to get a distortion. Similarly, your phone. So most of you have seen that your focal length in the phone would be around 4 point something. So it is an ultra wide angle lens. So it's a very good lens for landscapes, group photos and stuff like that, but it's not a great lens for portraits or even dental photography. The moment you use your phone for dental photography and documentation, you are going to suffer from distortion. So please don't use your phones for dental photography. So focal length is inversely proportional to distortion. Please note it down. This will be really helpful for all of you all. We had already discussed this on live one, but since we are talking about lenses, we have to talk about this and respect this even now. All right. Now let's talk about one more thing related to lens, that is the minimum focusing distance. Okay. You must have experienced this before. For example, my patient has come, and if you are into mobile phone photography, what you must have experienced is you are taking your phone and you're going close to the tooth like this, and you're trying to focus, but it's just not focusing. How many of you have experienced that? You're taking your phone and you're trying to focus, but it's just not focusing, and then you take a step behind and then suddenly it focuses. Tell me how many of you have experienced this truthfully. Okay, why this is happening is because you are not respecting the minimum focusing distance of the lens. Since this is related to the lens we have included in the topic today, every lens, for example, 50mm lens or anything like that, has a minimum focusing distance associated with it. Let us see what is the minimum focusing distance of this lens. So this is a 50mm lens, and the minimum focusing distance of this lens is written over here. It is 0.35 meters to or in other words is also 1.1 feet. So this is the minimum that this is the closest that you can go to your subject. Obviously you can go to infinity also and shoot. So the range of this lens is 0.35 meters to infinity, or you can say 1.1 feet to infinity. In the sense, I cannot go closer than 1.5 feet to my patient. All right. So focal length and minimum focusing distance are related to each other. How we are related to minimum focusing distance is like this. So suppose you can see that I'm at 18mm right now. So if I'm at 18mm, I can take a picture from hypothetical example. Okay, if I'm at 18mm, I can take a picture from here itself. All right. But if I increase my focal length, if I put it at 35, I can no longer shoot from this distance. I have to go far, maybe as much as this much. All right. So what I'm saying is, if the focal length is increasing, so is my minimum focusing distance. All right. So suppose if I move from 35 to 55, I cannot stand here also. I'll have to stand like this. So since I've increased my focal length, I cannot go very close to my subject. I have to stand far. So what I'm saying is, suppose if I have a 100mm lens, means a normal 100mm lens, not a macro 100mm lens, I would probably have to stand around 4 feet or behind from the patient. Now that just absolutely makes no sense for us, because as a dentist, we want to go as close to the subject and shoot so that the flash enters inside the patient's mouth, and I can take a good picture. But if it is a normal 100mm lens, I have to stand as far as 4.5 feet from the patient. Now in a clinic like mine, I have a clinic which is total area is 70 square feet. It is very difficult to have 4.5 feet from the patient. So I cannot use the 100mm lens, with the normal 100mm lens in my dental photography and documentation. So I need to have a special lens. That is why I invest on a macro lens. So macro lens, despite it being 100mm focal length, that means despite it being a telephoto lens, is specially engineered in such a way that you can come very close to the subject and shoot. So although this is a 100mm macro lens, and you could have stood 4.5 meters away if it was a normal lens, macro lens allows you to come as close as 6 inches to the patient and shoot. Hypothetically, what I'm saying is I'm allowed to come very, very close to the patient and shoot. So that's the beauty of a macro lens, and that is why you have to have a macro lens. So if you have a lens like 18-105, even that lens has 100 mm in it, but we cannot use that lens, because if you use that lens, you will have to stand very far from the patient and it will become a nightmare for you to use that lens. Similarly, you cannot use 24 105 lens or even 55 250 lens. Even a 55 250 lens has 100 in it, but you cannot use that lens because it is not a macro lens. So hopefully you've understood that you need to have a lens which has minimum focusing distance, which is less for dental photography and documentation. So hopefully I've spoken well about minimum focusing distance for you to understand it better.